Today we will show you how to build a simple acoustic levitator. For more information, check the video description. It can levitate liquids and solids. So let's get started. First of all, 3D print the attached file without support. Clean the base using a file and drill two holes at the sides. Now we need to mark the polarity of the transducers. For doing so, attach one to the scope and poke it with a thin wire. If the spike goes up, mark the positive leg. If the spike goes down, mark the negative leg. For doing it faster, stick two copper stripes to the table and attach the probes to them. Glue the transducers into the sockets with the marked legs pointing inwards. Wrap exposed wire around the pins in 6 concentric rings. To secure the contacts, solder the pins to the wire. We need 4 long wires with one side exposed, and 3 exposed areas in the other side. Solder the black wire to 3 non-marked legs, and the red one to 3 marked legs. Solder to secure them. You can tin the other sides. Solder the headers of the Arduino backwards, and program it with the provided source code. Now you can glue the Arduino and the driver. For the power supply, get a positive wire and a negative wire, and solder them to the DC barrel. You can apply shrink tubes to make it more secure. Solder the other end of the negative wire into the switch, and another wire into the switch. Apply shrink tubes and tin the ends. Glue the DC barrel and the power switch. Connect the positive power supply into the first socket of the driver. Connect the ground and the ground for the Arduino into the second socket, and the 5 volts for the Arduino into the third socket. Put a jumper between D10 and D11. Provide ground and voltage to the Arduino. Now connect the signals A0 to A3 into input 1 to input 4 and leave a free wire connected to ground. To test the driver, connect it to a power supply and test with a scope output 1 and output 2, or output 3 and output 4. Please be sure that there is no shortcut between the red and black wires. To test the transducers, connect the red and black wires to the driver. Switch it on and connect two transducers to two probes. Be sure that the positives go to the marked legs. All the transducers should be emitting and in phase. You can correct mistakes by bridging transducers or removing and resoldering them. For optimum operation, swap the wires and pick the one with minimum current consumption. Now that everything is ready, you can secure the wires with hot glue and glue the legs. Never apply more than 10 volts. For solid particles, you can use a tweezer or a small metallic grid. If you connect ground to D2, the particles will go down. To D3, they will go up. And D4, it will reset. For trapping liquids, you may need to reduce the voltage, otherwise droplets may pop. Put a tiny styrofoam particle to guide your placement. Use a syringe with a 1 mm needle, bent and with the tip removed. Be sure to have fabric on the bottom to avoid damaging the transducers when the droplets fall.